राइट. ओके मुकुल, सो कैन आई स्टार्ट? यस. ओके ऑल राइट. सो वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू एवरीबडी.
शुड आई स्टॉप शेयर?
या या, प्लीज स्टॉप शेयरिंग योर दिस थिंग. आई विल शेयर इट फ्रॉम माई दिस थिंग. Are you doing it, Mukul? Hello? ओके फाइन. सो एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस यू आर अपूर्वा.
ओके ऑल राइट. वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबडी एंड वेलकम टू दिस थ्री सेशन ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम इन एक्सेल. सो जस्ट लेट मी स्टार्ट शेयरिंग माई स्क्रीन. Yes. So can you see my screen now?
Yes.
Okay. All right. So I'll just quickly revise what we saw yesterday. Okay. So we began with the basics of Excel. We saw things about basic formatting of cells, rows and columns, which included, you know, things like putting your borders on and off, merging cells, the importance of merging or unmerging cells. Then we looked at why it was important to ensure that none of the cells in your sheet are merged, because otherwise it creates problems in your pivot tables and other things. Then we briefly saw how to convert text to columns. In case you have multiple entries with a space or a particular character in one column, how do you separate those entries? So that is what we saw. We saw different types of find and replace. Okay. We also looked at something called go to, with which you can fill in all empty cells in a column at one shot. That is one thing that we saw. We saw very basic things like how to hide and unhide columns. Okay. Then we saw the importance of Format Painter, freeze panes, how it helps, you know, to retain the top row as you scroll down. Then we briefly saw about named ranges, how you can name either a single cell or a group of cells in Excel. You can assign a name to it. Okay. After that, we moved on to sorting and filtering. So sorting is basically arranging data. Filtering is only seeing that data which is relevant to you. Okay. So this is the basic difference. Then we saw different types of filters, including a custom filter. Okay. An advanced filter. We saw how to custom sort data based on different levels. Then we looked at different formulae. Okay, we looked at it very briefly. You know, there are more than 400 functions in Excel, so we could not cover all of that, but we tried to touch upon it. And in data visualization, we saw a part which is pivot tables and pivot charts. Okay, pivot tables help you compress your data, okay, analyze it in a summarized manner. Okay, so that is the main use of pivot tables. They are extremely flexible. You can have any kinds of pivot tables depending on what your requirement is, and you can create extremely interesting dashboards. We also saw about slicers. Okay, so slicers along with pivot tables can help you create very nice dashboards. Then we saw, in brief, we saw about what formula auditing means, how to trace dependents and precedents for a particular cell, and how to, you know, enable the show formulas button. And then we saw how to scale your sheet so that it can be printed nicely. And some small feature, there was this small thing called saved workspace, wherein you can view two files at one shot. So we might have seen a couple of things here and there, but this was an overview of what we saw yesterday. So today we will be, you know, leveraging the things that we saw yesterday. All right. And the first part will be covered by me. I'll be speaking for around 10 to 15 minutes. And I'll be covering a couple of points. After which I'll be handing over the session to Mukul, who will, with the help of very interesting examples, be explaining key concepts like how to import data, you know, how to use a solver or how to create a data entry form and so on. Okay, and then we'll be moving on to one very, very interesting example. Hats off to you, Mukul, for coming up with this wonderful example. I'm sure all of you will definitely enjoy this. It is about how to integrate maps with color coding into Excel. Okay, so that is about it. And let me start with the part that I'm supposed to cover. I'll have to switch my screen. Just give me half a second. Yes, so can you see my screen? Can you see an Excel sheet?
Yes.
Okay, thank you very much. Yes, so the first point that I'm going to cover today is data validation. Okay, so just let me show you one thing now. This is the same data that we were, you know, looking at yesterday. Okay, I have just shortened it a bit because so that, you know, this system does not become slow. So just let me show you one thing. Okay, now this data, just imagine that it has come from the field. Okay, so it has been filled up by, say, some field workers or anyone who is out there and not very savvy in data entry. All right, so let us just look at this column called anemia. All right, so I'm just clicking over here and let me see the options that are coming here. Okay, so these are basically the unique entries which are appearing in this column. All right, so I see mild, moderate, no anemia, no AN, no data, okay, none. So let me just see only the things which are related to no anemia, okay, not anemic, not anemic, not anemic. You see, so many things. These, all of these actually mean the same thing, okay. So these are all meaning not anemic, okay, but due to some data entry error, it is appearing as this. Now this will give me problems if I try to count it. Okay, if I want to find out the number of mild, moderate and non-anemic cases, this will create problems for me. So this can be avoided in two ways. One is during post-processing, you will have to manually sit down and select all these. And then as we did yesterday, you can replace all of them with a common text. Okay, so that is post-mortem. That is after the mistake has been done. But what you can also do is, right at the time of data entry, you can restrict. Okay, so that is called data validation. Let me just show you. So this column is again anemia. So if you see now, I can enter anything here, right? There is no limitation on what I should be entering in this column.
Apurva, can I stop you for a minute? Your voice is kind of fluctuating. Can you speak closer to the mic?
Yes. I'm actually using a headphone. Is it audible now?
Yeah, it is audible now.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. Yeah. So I was just mentioning that, you know, if there is this new column without any data validation, okay? So I can type in anything over here. Okay, there is no restriction. All right. So this is what happens and this is what creates these kind of problems. Okay, multiple kinds of spellings for the same thing. To avoid this, what we can do is we can select this cell, we can go to the data tab, click here, data validation, okay, go here, data validation, and if you see here, validation criteria, okay, if I just click over here now, you can set the kind of input that you want to go into this cell, all right, so whole number, decimal, list, data, date, time, length, text length, custom, okay, anything. All right, so just let us choose list. All right, so basically what this means is this cell can contain data only from a particular list of text. All right, so in our case, it is just not anemic, mild, moderate, severe, and no data. As we saw, in some cells there is no data. All right. So I'm putting these entries over here and I'm clicking OK. And now if you see, there's a small button, small down arrow, which is appearing on the right hand side of this cell. If I click, this entire list appears here. Okay. So I just select this. Okay. Or I select this, not anemic. Okay. Now what happens if I try to enter something? So ABC. Okay. It gives me an error. The value you entered is not valid. The user has restricted values that can be entered into this cell. Okay. So this is how you can stop unwanted, you know, you can avoid errors right at the time of data entry. So right now what we saw was just a list. Okay, you can go ahead and you can explore these other options as well. Okay, you can restrict the text length, you can set the time, date, whatever it is. You can also say it is between so and so and so and so. Okay, so each of these has got these operators, okay, between, not between, equal, whatever. So there you have got a wide variety of options to choose from and ensure that your data entry happens in a good way, okay, without any errors. So that was briefly about data validation. This is very powerful, especially when your data is going to come from different sources, or you know that in a particular column you are going to have entries only from a particular set of numbers or strings or whatever it is. Alright, so that was about data validation. Yes, just let me show you one more thing. So what happens if I apply data validation on a column which already has data? Okay, so just let me put in. Sorry. This column already has data. I'm just trying to apply data validation here now. Okay, so in this case, what you can do is you can go here and you can say circle invalid data. Okay, so it will circle the data which is not in the given range of text. Okay, you see this? But only thing is, you cannot, it is not possible to filter it from here. You cannot filter those cells with circles. So you will have to like manually go down and change those. But at least there is a way of finding out what is going wrong. Okay. So rather than a postmortem, we suggest that it is always good to put in data validation right in the beginning. Okay, and then you can clear the validation circles. Okay. Sorry. Clear validation circles. Data validation, any value. All right. So that was the first topic that I wanted to cover. There is another thing. It's a very small feature, but might be useful. It is something called watch. Okay. So it is as if basically you want to watch a particular variable. All right. You want to see how it performs. Your data is, you know, being added over here, or, you know, you're doing some operations over here and you want to continuously trace one variable. Okay, so how do you do that? So let me show you. Now here I've just made a sheet called watch, and here what I've done is I've just put a small formula which says count if. Okay, it's a count if. So this will count only if the cell has this particular value which I mentioned over here. So basically what I'm trying to do is, from this WAZ column in my previous sheet, WAZ malnutrition column from my previous sheet, I just want to count the cases which are moderately wasted. Okay, so that corrective action can be taken on them right in time. Okay, so this cell basically is the count of moderately wasted malnutrition cases. I have just put it out here and I have right clicked it and I have defined a name, okay, count of WAZ malnutrition. So this cell is basically count of WAZ malnutrition. Now what I want to do is I want to keep a track on the count of moderately malnourished, moderately wasted cases. So what I do is I go to formulas, I add a watch window, Okay, and here I can add a parameter that I want to watch. Okay, so I can go here and I can select this cell and I can say add. So now this window, it also gets here. So this window basically keeps on floating no matter in which sheet you move to. Okay, so this like permanently remains here. So what I've done is I want to watch this parameter. I want this parameter to be visible to me even as I am navigating through the sheets. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go to the formulas tab. I'm going to click watch window. Okay, I'll just delete this for the time being. And here I click add a watch. Okay, add watch. And you just have to select the cell that you want to watch. So I am going to this watch sheet and I am selecting this cell that I want to watch. Okay, and I say add. So it gets added to this. I can adjust the width of these columns. I just want the name and the value, for instance. So I make the other columns shorter. Okay. So this is how I can watch. Now say, for example, if there is some additional data which is added to my sheet. Okay, do you see now? It was 29 earlier. The count of such cases was 29 and now it is 30. Okay, so I can keep a watch on this parameter. I can add other parameters here as well. I can drag and make this window big. Okay, so this is how you can use the watch window. Okay, this was a very simple example in a complex sheet. I'm sure this function will be useful. All right, so that was about watch. Now next, let's do one thing. Okay, so do you see these small cute graphs over here? Let's see how we can make those. Okay, I'm just deleting this. Now these are called spark lines. All right, so here I have got some sample data of road accidents, which I have taken from the Government of India website, just for sample. Okay, so basically I need some data which is varying across time. All right, or basically I have one state over here and I have a similar data of road accidents across years. So that is the kind of data that I have. And I just want to visually understand the number of such cases quickly. Okay, so what I do is I go to insert, I go to this blank cell first, I go to insert and I go to line. Okay, so if you click here, it says insert line spark line. Okay, so data range is this, because this is the graph that I want to plot, and location where I want the graph is L2. Okay, and then I click okay. So you can have it in a line form, okay, or you can have it in a column form or win loss. So you can have different formats as per what you require. Then you can also highlight the high and the low points. Okay, do you see now here the highest point has been highlighted in light blue. Okay, you can change the colors. Okay, and I'm just dragging it below. So all the rows also get this spark line. Now one thing that you can do is you can just select all these rows. You can go to axis. And right now what it has done is, you see now here it is actually 44,000 cases. Okay, and here it is just 263. But these are actually not showing correctly, because Excel is automatically scaling this to the data that you are handling. Okay, but if I want the scale to be absolute, okay, I don't want it to change with my data. So I have to go to design. I have to select these cells. I have to go to axis and I can select here. Same for all spark lines. Okay, and here also same for. So now you see it has scaled it down and all these are now at the same scale. Okay, so I can compare as well. So this is a small feature in data visualization that we can use. okay, especially in terms of variables which are like varying over a range of time, this feature can be used. Now the last thing that I want to cover is conditional formatting. Okay, so basically conditional formatting is a tab which appears here on your home button, on your home tab. Okay, and it gives you the liberty to highlight cells based on certain rules or based on certain criteria. Okay, so this is a part of data visualization. So now say for instance, I want to highlight, let's consider height in centimeters, let's consider that column. So in case I want to highlight all the cells that have height more than 100 centimeters. Okay, so I'll just say new rule, format all cells based on their value. Okay, or rather than that, there is a simpler shortcut here, highlight cell rules greater than 100, for instance. Okay, and here I can choose in what way I want to highlight that cell, and you can custom format it as well. So right now I'm leaving it at the default option, light red fill with dark text. Okay, so I've done that. Now what you can do is you can click over here. Acha, so how do you enable these filters is you go to the data tab and you click on filter. That will enable this small arrow over here. So you click over here, and here there is something which appears which is called filter by color. Okay, so by that way you can filter out all these values which are more than 100. Now no data it is considering as more than 100, but that is an error. You can like put in some other value there, and or you can change your rule and get rid of this as well. Okay, so this was just one very simple example of your conditional formatting. You can create number of formulae, overlap them on the same cell. Okay, so just let me clear the rules. Okay, so now just look at this column. Okay, I'll just click over here. I'll just first show you what options are available. So basically you can highlight cells depending on a variety of criteria. Okay, greater than, less than, between, equal to, or a text that contains a particular string, a date, duplicate values. Okay, you can also highlight them based on the top or bottom items, or above and below average. Okay, it is very flexible. You can just keep on experimenting. You can also visually see these as data bars. Okay, so I had selected only one column, that's why it happened like that. So just let me select this data bars. Okay, so these appear as small bars depending on the value which is there. Okay, now if you see over here, this cell has a data bar as well as the red color. Why? Because we have conditionally formatted it that in case it is more than 100, the cell needs to be highlighted in red color. Okay, so you can overlap rules, and all the rules you'll be able to see here when you go to conditional formatting, manage rules. Okay, you'll be able to see all the rules that exist in this sheet. All right, so here I've just applied one small kind of conditional formatting. I'll just show it to you. Manage rules, so it is called icon set. Okay, so basically what I have done is, I'll go to edit rule. Okay, I have selected icon sets. So icon sets are basically a set of symbols which you can assign to this cell based on the value. So now based on the malnutrition value, if it is greater than 2, it is green, top arrow green. Okay, right yellow arrow is between 2 and minus 3. So you can basically, you can put any values over here, not an issue. Okay, so I have done this. Okay, and you see here, it is very nicely visible over here. Okay, so you can put in different kinds of options. How much you want to play. Okay, that part. I have covered data validation, conditional formatting, sparklines, and watch. So with that, I am done. we can take all the questions later on. You can please put them in the chat box as we are speaking. And over to you, Mukul. I'll stop my screen share now. Or is it already stopped? Yeah, stop share.
Hello, everyone. So Apurva have covered the first four points. So I will start with the basic formulas, continue with the basic formulas that we were playing yesterday also. But I will add some of the formulas into it and try to make an sequence of the formulas, an example. So so we will start with the first example. This is the file name, session 1, 2, right to left. So this is the same data as used in the yesterday's session. Okay. So I have removed all the sheets except this process sheet in the thing, in the file. So when we usually go to field, we select, we sample the data and we select few of the villages and few farmers, let's say examples of farmers. We select few farmers in the sample and from 3 to 4 different villages. Then we do not usually give serial number to 1 to 50. We wanted that each village has villages has number from should have serial numbers. Like for example, if we take districts in Maharashtra, Ahmednagar, if I have selected 50 samples, 50 farmers, so each like Ahmednagar data set should have 1 to 50 as a serial number, while Buldana should also have 1 to 50 farmer number. So there is one thing, code should be generalized, which should have state name, district name in this case, as well as serial number. So such code, I could not understand anything. But for that, I will first filter the data of these districts. So for that, I will use advanced filter. This was covered by Apurva. So I will be quickly using it. Data, advance, filter in place. Instead of filter in place, I will use copy to another location, list range. I will select the data. Then copy to, criteria range. I should select criteria range, which is written in the sheet 2 itself. Okay. So copy to, it should be in sheet 2. Okay, this is small thing. If I click on OK, then it will be error saying that you can only filter data to the active sheet. Okay, so data where data we want in the sheet 2. So sheet 2 should be active and then we should click on advanced. What I done before is this sheet was active and I tried to export data in sheet 2. So that will give 100% error. If you wanted data in sheet 2, then sheet 2 should be active. Go to advanced. Again, do the same thing. List range. Select the range from A2 till. I'm using Control Shift right arrow and down arrow to select the all the list. These shortcuts are already told you in yesterday's session. Again, sheet 1, select criteria range, copy to another location, select location A2, A1, and okay. So I have done this thing. So in my problem statement, I don't want this as my ID. I want, for example, MA, like for Maharashtra, I will be using MA as initials. For Ahmedabad, I will be using AH as initials. So MA, AH, 0001 or MA AH0002 kind of sequence I will be using. So for that I need to extract first two letters of this Maharashtra or this cell. I need also need to extract first two cells of this district. So I will generate column state code, again one column district code. So for that I can use write function. There is a write function. So what it will do is it will extract text from write. It has two arguments. One is what text you are from what text you will extract the things, and what number of characters do you want. So I want MA is two letters, so I will use two here, and it will generate. Okay, it should be left, not right, sorry. So it will extract two letters from left. Yeah, I have already explained about write function here. One more function is there, mid. So if I want middle these three characters, let's say HAR, her. So what I will do equal to mid. So mid text, I will select text. And from which character I want the data? Third character, because MAHH is third letter. And number of character I want is three. So I will choose three. So it will give HAR. So that way, similarly, I could able to write a function for this district code also. In this case, I will choose this thing, left E2, comma 2. So, okay. Now, what I want is, I will sort the data by some month, age in months, let's say, sort A to Z. So that now what happened is, this is MA, this is these districts are MA, have code this thing. So I will join this both the things together. What I am doing is just developing a serial number, like what we have roll number 18335001. So 18335 is for Sitara and kind of different is serial number. Some similar thing I am trying to do here for dataset. So for joining these two, one thing you can do is equal to this, and you can use AND character, shift 7, AND character, and select another thing. So this will join together and form different code. Secondly, you can use concatenate function. So in that you can join n number of texts. So I will start with state, district, state code, district code, let's say, okay, and enter. What happened? Okay, this should not be G2. So you can see in the cell, it is Maharashtra, Ahmednagar, and lastly MS, because we chose F2 only. So using concatenate.
Mukul, can I stop you for a minute?
Yeah.
There has been a request that if possible to increase the size of your screen or font size. Somebody is finding it difficult to read the text when compared to Apurva's screen.
Okay. Is it okay, fine?
Thank you. Yeah, it seems fine.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. So I will use this function to join both the codes and drag it down there line. So for this is Hingoli, sorry. Okay, So this is Hingoli. It had generated HI as a code, and Mahi is the now code for general code. So if I delete these two rows, then it will give error. Like this is explained by Apurva. So I will just copy and paste as value directly, so that now I can remove these two rows which are not needed now. So this is one. Now what I want to do is generate serial numbers. So for example, this is MH. So this should be one, this would two, this should be one again, because this is first Mabu. This should be two, this should be three, such thing. For that, what should I use? You have Apurva told you the formula for it is count if range is this thing and criteria is MAH. So what it will do is count all the MAH before the row. For that, I have to fix F2, second row, in using dollar, but I should keep this dynamic so that if I drag this down, look at this, F2 is constant, it will go to F4. So it will count all the MABU from this range. For this, it will count all MAH from this range to this range. You can see in the formula. This is again a use of dollar. So this, I will drag this formula. So I get village wise or district wise serial number for the, let's say, children in this case, because this is children data. So this is serial number. Okay, so if I go down the below, there are 221 kids. So code for this should be generalized code for this should be MAH001. So there should be two zeros before one, because last code will be MAH221 or something like that. So how will I add zeros here? So there are things you can do in home tab is here. So you can go to home. There are several different options here: number, current, currency, accounting, long. You can you can go to custom or more number formats. You will find custom here, and here instead of at the rate, you can type three zeros, because you want three numbers, like three digit number. So I think so I should happening. Okay, I will repeat it again. Go to numbers, custom, instead of general, write three zeros. So sample, it is showing 001. So this is what we want. So this is what happened. So this is one thing. For like, if you want continuous zero, repetitive zero, repetitive character, you can use rept, REPT, rept of text. What you want to repeat is zero, number of times two. So there will be two zeros. So this is also one of the formula, but that will be too long. So I have changed the format. Now I can use concatenated or use and function. So I will use and function to join this. But what happened is all leading zeros went off. This is because formula Excel is stating this 001 as a number, while MAH is text. So we should use convert this number, G2 number, into text. For that, you can use text of value is G2, and format of text, as I explained, it should be 30, because we want 3-digit number. So this is final formula for generating code. So you can now check randomly. So MARA 12. So there should be 11 MARA values here. So if I sorted district wise, you can get that thing. So for sort, you should go to data, sort A to Z. Okay. I didn't choose, I think so. My data has header, and then age in months. Instead of age in months, I will again sort with the districts. So all the MAH links will be getting sequentially generated data. This is the final code. So I will go to the again worksheet. So I covered right, left, leading zeros, concatenate, ripped, and number format. Yeah, you can always go to the number formats from here in home. So there are already, there are many number formats, for example date, but yeah, you can go through many of these, and you can have a custom number formats using this type by typing here only directly. Also there is one thing, you can have decimal places, adding and deleting below the special character, below the custom this thing. So this is also one of the function. So I will move to the next example, importing data. So that for that I will use India.gis file. I will close this file now. For India.gis file, okay, so for the importing, I will just delete this table. Okay, so this is one website where there is a one table which has the data of state, population area and population density. So what I want to use this data, this is static data, but there might be some dynamic data that I have to use. So for static data, I can directly copy paste this and paste in the Excel kind of thing, do cleaning and kind of thing. But for dynamic data, I have to import it. So how to do it? So go to the data tab. Data tab, you will find get data from web directly here. Get data from other sources. You can import data from other files, database and kind of thing, but we'll go to from web. So it is asking me URL. So I will copy the URL of this file directly, paste it. Okay. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Search box will be pop up. Okay. This is India Today. You can look at the web view. This is how it is looking. Sorry. So this table is now in the listing. You can format it here only. and then close and load. So all the data will be imported in the sheet. Like this is like getting data from web, and this is updated. So we have got the data from web, imported data from web. So this is the trick. Now we'll go back to the Excel workshop. This is, I have completed this importing data. We'll get back to IndiaJS example once again while looking into it. So now, okay. If I wanted like for, I will use data validation again in this cell so that I to make a drop down list, which is explained by Apurva already. So data adjacent to text2 column below the line, here it is data validation. Any value, instead of any value, I will use list. In cell drop down, ignore blank, source I will be giving it from A2 to okay. So I got the drop down list, Karnataka. I can choose anything. So what I want in this cell is population in the cell of J3 according to what I am changing here. Telangana kind of thing, Chhattisgarh kind of thing. So how will I do it? So there is a formula called VLOOKUP. So it has four parameters. One is lookup value. What you want to look? We want to look for this value, which is Chhattisgarh. Secondly, you have to give array or range. So our range is from A2 to below the line. So I have given an array 13. It requires is number of rows and columns. So for okay, I will put 1 as of now. I will explain that. So okay. So here it will ask for row offset, and this is column offset. So I will explain what is row offset and column offset first. So if this is cell A2, and compared to this A2, if I want to go to Maharashtra or A3, so I want to go one cell down. So that is row offset of 1. From A2 to, I want to go to row offset. Second is column offset. So that is going here. If I consider my reference cell as A2 and I went to the C5, then my row offset is 1, 2, 3 rows down the below. So my row offset will be 3 rows, while column offset will be 1, 2. Second row. So that will be used here. So it will look Chhattisgarh value in the array. So it will ask, VLOOKUP will ask column index. So which column do you want? Population column we want. So population column is at which number of column, which number of column? State is zeroth number, population is first. If I am not wrong, and last parameter it will ask is exact match or appropriate match. In most of the cases we use exact match, so it will give a exact value. For if data is not that good, then sometimes approximate match will work, but preferably we will use exact match only. So this is first.
No,
is
it will be 2.
It will be 2.
It is, okay. Starts 1, 2.
Yeah, 1, 2. So for array, first value is first column, second value is second column, third value is third column. So if we want area instead of population, so that value should be third column. So that column index should be third in the formula. Yeah, it came here directly. Is that okay? Any doubt regarding VLOOKUP? Okay, so I will move ahead. You try VLOOKUP, like it is very useful while working with two different sheets having some different sequence. So to matching the values, you can use that VLOOKUP. So again, if I want this, like there is one problem if state population area and population density are in row one. But if I want state population area, because like if I want transpose of it, I want horizontal table instead of vertical level, then what should I do? Then there is a simple trick, Control C, select all, Control C. I will make a new sheet for this. Right click or paste special. Right click, paste special, or go to home. From home, you will have paste special. And there is a there are all kind of things you can do from here. So I don't know why is transpose not there. I will copy it again.
Mukul. Transpose works with only one column or one row, not with multiple rows or multiple columns.
Are you sure? Okay, we'll do
yes,
that.
Yes.
Okay, so we'll transpose the data. There is a shortcut also. Here is transpose, but we'll go to paste special and you can select transpose here. You can paste only values or formulas or formats. So let's do formats, formulas. So
transpose works with multiple rows and columns for entire table, but you have to copy the data, not cut it.
Yeah,
yes,
that should work.
You have to copy the data.
Yeah, I have copied data, but it is not working. I don't know. I will try again. Okay, I got the point. So first of all, this is in table format, so that is why it's giving error. If you remove this table format, for that you have to go to insert. No. Home. So no, not home. Actually, design. There is a design option here, and there should be a clear. So this is a design of table. So Apurva explained table designs here. So you can clear table format from here. So now this is normal table. And now if we copy this and paste here, file, home, paste special, you will get an option.
I think it is about pasting in the same sheet.
Filter aega.
Paste in same sheet.
No, you can paste it in other sheet. Some other mistake perhaps.
Yeah, I don't know this thing, but yeah, this is working. This is what I pasted as value, and then I can use transport. Yeah, I can use in another sheet also. That's yes. The only issue. Yeah, I don't know what is the issue. That is table formatting imported data. That's why that might not be working. Okay, so this is the horizontal table, and now if we want to do the same thing as we did in the sheet 2, looking for the value of population, this thing. So I will copy whole thing in the new sheet. So I want to change this. Okay, now what I have to modify the data validation. So again, we'll go to data validation, list. I will select the states. Instead of this, I will go to I got the list of the states here. So you can check that. Now, if I want area of Chhattisgarh, VLOOKUP will not work here. For that, you have to use HLOOKUP. V stand for vertical, while H stand for horizontal. So now we are looking for horizontal thing, looking C9 value. That's okay. In the array is changed, I think. In the array, this one, we have to choose these values. Okay, so this is now this is not a column index, this is row index. So row index is which how many numbers down the row you have to select. So first it will find the Chhattisgarh in this first cell, first row, and after that it will go to third row because we have given a row index as a 3. So this is similar to VLOOKUP, but some changes are there. Like horizontal, instead of vertical, it looks in horizontal values. So can I move to the next topic? Okay, importing data from Google Sheet. That was query from yesterday's session. So similar to so we will use this participants data to import data. That is Google Sheet itself. So this is the sheet. So I will share it and use this shared link. Okay. So I will copy this link so that I can import it in the this example. This is blank sheet now. So data. Import from web. Okay, I will copy paste this link of the spreadsheet. But for spreadsheet, I have to do some changes. So there will be edit USP sharing or view question mark USP equal to sharing, something like that. So for that we have to delete it. Instead of that we have to use export question mark type equal to xlsx and then you can click OK. That's the small trick. Then you can import Google Sheets also. So you will get number of sheets here. So feedback is one of the sheet in that workbook, while sheet one is where all of data of all of the participants is available. So I can click on load and it will load the data. So this is how you can import any Google Sheet. And now one can change any cell. So basically I will change Kritika's how understanding about Excel in this participant list. So Kritika is here. There is blank here. Now I can write one or two or three, I don't know. I will write one. So this is not reflected here. For that you have to refresh it. Refresh is in design column here or data data refresh. Both the things there is refresh things, so it is reflected one here. Okay, so we'll play with this participant data now for some time. I will delete all the, so this data is now deleted. If I delete this from here in sheet and if we press refresh again, then it it will again come. For to avoid this, again will change a little bit. Queries and connections. Okay. Existing connections. Yeah. There you can look at the existing connection. Okay. Like we'll delete and import data again by changing some things. Export question mark type equal to XLSX. Okay. So instead of directly loading the thing, you can click on sheet one, transform data, or okay, transform data. So another window will be opening up. Okay, this is one. So you can do anything here, and that will allow you to change imported data. Like there are many columns which are not required, which are being imported in the sheet. So remove that directly. Column 9 is not required. You can remove errors, you can change the formats. Like if you click here, you can see ABC. Okay, so I will, okay. This is now ABC, this is number format. So it is showing 1, 2, 3, while this is ABC, because there are text in this columns. So I will delete this also. Okay, that's it. 7, 8 rows we can import, and 1000 rows it is importing. That's okay. Close and load. So getting data. Yeah, so this is one. Now even if we refresh, that other extra rows will not come. So this is one data. So now I want to know, what are the number of count of people which are at Excel level 1? So this is Excel level, and this is count. So Apurva, I have given you count formula is equal to count if 0 Yeah, Mayank is just asking that if this data is changes in the Google sheet is reflected in the sheet or not. So yeah, it is reflected. So this is the sheet. I can edit anything here. For column 3, I will write, for example, 1 again, and I will open the Excel sheet. So for this column 3, this is not yet reflected, but if we click on refresh is in design tab, refresh is there, or data tab. For all such tables we can click refresh all, but for this table we can click this also from design tab to refresh. So this is reflected.
Mukul, just to interrupt you, sorry, I think the query was the other way around. So if you change here, it will not go to the Google sheet, right?
No, it will not go to Google sheet. Vice versa is, as of now, vice versa is not possible using this method. There are different methods. Okay, so what I will come back to the example. I want to use count. So count if I will be using, this is the value I want to count in the range. Okay, first of all I will remove this table format, because I am not familiar with the table format. Clear. I will format this first in a minute. text. Okay, so again go to the activities, count if. Okay, so count, I want to go to this sheet. I will select the range. Okay, so G22, G1001, comma, criteria. Criteria is zero or this row, enter. Again, I will explain about dollar sign. If I horizontally drag it, then what is happening is this is changing as to criteria is changing, C1. Here is D1, but this range also is changing. So we have to fix that range, or we have to make a dollar before G. Okay, then this will work. Okay, so I want to find maximum of people who have these values. So this is 51 having this thing. So next step is I have found that for third level knowing people there is only one count, and I want to know who is it. So I can't use actually VLOOKUP or HLOOKUP for finding value of 3 in the this fifth column, G column, and give me who is it or name of it. For that I have to use different formula. So I will explain it in a bit. Formula names are index and match, both I have to use together. So match will return me the offset value of the cell, while index will find that value. So we'll start with match. We have to match third three value. Lookup value is 3. Lookup array is G cell, this G column, comma, exact match, less than match or greater value. Usually we use exact match, and enter. So it is giving back me 30. What does that mean? So this means if we go to the 30th column from 30th row from first cell, then you will get a 3 value. 30th means 30 plus 3, 33. So here it is, 31. So 30 from first column. So first 1 plus 30 is 30. That is giving me match, like row offset from the array. Hello. Okay. Hello, Apurva.
Yes, go on. Yes.
Yeah. Should we repeat to VLOOKUP and HLOOKUP?
You can continue. I'll just check on the chat. Okay. You can continue with this. I'll just check. Okay.
So this is what match did to us. Now we have to go to name column. We have to start with this first row, second row, and we have to go to till 30th row so that we can get name. This is 30th row, which has 3 value. 30 is given by a match to us. So we'll start with index. Index returns a value or reference cell. So we'll get array. Array in this case is we want name, or we can give whole this thing, but we want name, so we can use only name. Row number is given by us by match number. This is row number, while column number is 1. So this is what match index can do. We can use negative or something. Okay, instead of only one row, we can use also from email also. You can start with email. Okay. So row number here will be changing. It will be three. Because first row is serial number, second is email, third is name. So column number here will be three. So that is giving me back a value of lookup value. So this is about it. Next topic. Okay. So one more thing I want to share with you is simple graphs. So I will use this to make a bar graph. Insert bar graph. So this is what happened, but I wanted my Excel level as a x-axis and count as a y-axis. So I will go to select data, remove first thing. Count will be remaining there and edit this thing to Excel level. I will select that data. Okay. I can go to count and change my name to kind of thing. And this is range. This is selected like this. Okay. So now this is not well formatted. So I will format it quickly by going into home tab, changing its color. Increasing font, adding axis title by right click on it, go to format axis. So format axis is open now. You can have these four tabs here. So fill, line, kind of things are there. So you can use solid line where black color is preferably used. Secondly, in axis tab, you can set a minimum and a maximum. I can start with minus 60 here, or I can choose 0. So the 0 is fine for this graph. So let's say okay. You can change also measure. So this is coming out to 0, 10, 20 range. So you can make it 5. So it will start with 5, count of 5, and it is ending at 55. You can end at 50 also, depending upon what data we have. So I will reset this. Okay, similar to this axis, I will change the axis title and all kind of thing. Solid line and solid line. Okay. I want to change this color also to some other color, let's say blue. Okay, and this is one graph. I will add some random values here. So I want to add another graph having different like count of different session, like let's say this is session one. This is session 2. So I want a graph of this also. So similarly, I chose the this thing, insert graph data, insert graph. Okay, so I changed the data again. I removed first thing, second I selected this thing. Now what has happened is format of the graph, new graph is also by default it is coming, but I want new format. That is I have changed the font color, font size and kind of thing. So how will I do that? thing. So I will just copy this or change the graph. Go to home tab, select second graph, and go to paste. Go to paste special, and paste as format. Okay. So that graph is format is already copied. So this can be used while making different graphs and keeping the same format. This is one thing. Second, I will now do another thing. I will use max if function. If this is maximum is equal to maximum of these values, then give me maximum, else give me blank. I don't want any value. So there will be only one value maximum and rest will be blank. So I will put a dollar wherever required in this range. I think so.
Yeah, there's an extra parenthesis, I think, after max. The first max on the left side.
1 minute. Okay.
Yeah, just check the first max after. Yeah, I think there's an extra parenthesis there.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you. So this is one formula I have written. So it will give me only maximum value and this will be blank. So okay, so why I am doing this is if I want to just highlight a maximum value in the with different color, then what I will do is design, select data, add new series name is session 2, or we will write maximum and select this range. Okay, so this series will be and this will be 0 to 1 to 3. Okay. So this will come along with the line. Okay. So for that, you can go to you can click on this series option. You will get this series format data series, or right click on this and format data series. You will get this window. So for that, you can use now these two things, series overlap, go to the 100%, and both the series will be overlap, while gap width is between the this thing. So this is one thing. And if I change now the color of the only series 2 to, let's say, maximum is red. So this is how it will be conditional formatting. So if I select this series, color of this series will be different. So it might be orange, let's say. Okay, so if I change this to, instead of minimum, I change this to maximum minimum, then that is also possible. Then minimum value will be This is a trick, like overlapping the things and getting conditional graph conditionally formatted. So this is minimum wala thing. So minimum wala thing is red now, rest are orange. So this is how you can use tricks for array formula. Due to time constraint, I won't explain it, but you can use the link given in the workbook. There is a video about it. So array formula is for I will shortly take an example. So this is
Mukul, sorry to interrupt. Due to constraint of time, some of the participants have mentioned that they would like to understand VLOOKUP once more.
Yeah.
So I think instead of covering something new, it would be good if you can just quickly
cover VLOOKUP.
Revise VLOOKUP.
Okay. So I will be using VLOOKUP file. So for VLOOKUP, I will not do data validation. I will type directly now. For example, I will type Rajasthan here. Now, second thing is, I want a value of some of the parameter related to Rajasthan, not all the values from the table, only value of Rajasthan from the table. Let's say, for example, population density I wanted. Density from this table. So for that, I can use VLOOKUP. So V is for vertical. What I want to do is vertically look the value in this table. Vertically, what we should look up, Rajasthan we should look up, and then give value of population density. So population density is 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, fourth from the column thing. So for VLOOKUP, it will ask you what value you should look up. So this is Rajasthan, you should look up in the table array. So what is array? Array, this is table, our table. So I have chose this table. Column index is 4 because we are looking at population density. Population density is fourth from the state. Like state is first, population is second, area is third, population density is fourth. So we are giving fourth column and we are using exact match. So it should return population density of Rajasthan. So if I used Bihar instead, so it should change the value to Bihar's population density. Hello. So is it okay? Have you got the point? So instead of population density, if I want area, then all other things will remain same. Only this column thing, which is 4 for population density, that should be area. So that will be 1, 2, 3, third column. Okay. So I will put it. So it will give me value of area for Bihar. So if I change again to some other state, Gujarat, it will automatically update it. So if you have a list of such data and another list having different order of the states, like this is not alphabetically sorted, but there is some another sheet. Okay, so everyone is clear about this VLOOKUP now. So instead of VLOOKUP, you can have HLOOKUP, horizontal thing. So that will go through the horizontal thing and return value in that horizontal thing. This is same like H lookup is transpose of V lookup. But limitation of H lookup and V lookup is you should have first row. This is first row. It won't give ID. Like if I write here ID 1, 2. So okay. So now if I want ID, so I can't write here -1. -1 will return nothing. So value you are looking should be in the first column of the your array. This is the limitation of VLOOKUP, HLOOKUP. So now I will explain index match again here also. Equal to match lookup value Gujarat, lookup array is this one. Okay, match type is exact. So it will give me find Gujarat for me, that is in 10th column, 10th from state. So we selected array as from the state, so it is 10th from state. So it is returning 10. So now if I want index, then see ID, then I use index. What is array? Array I will choose from ID. Yeah, if I count state as first, second is Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, and 10th. So it is 10th. In formula, I use from state. So that is giving me a 10 value. So same thing I will do for similar array. Okay, so if I change select this table directly, so this is array. So what row number I should go? Row number of 10. What is column number? Column number is my one ID is in one first column, so I can use first. So this is 9th. So ID of Gujarat is 9th, or I can choose it to Maharashtra or Kerala. Kerala, it will give me 13. Yeah, it is reflecting 13. So for index, you can I will combine this together now. Formula match index together. So instead of okay, I will clear this table now so that rows formula will be generated. List as value. So okay, so is equal to match in state. So I will choose this state. So this is B1 to B30, lookup value, adjacent, match, exact. So I will write something Kerala here. Lookup value should be adjacent. Okay. Comma. Oh, sorry. Okay, this is 14. So I got the match, and before match I will write index. So this is index of array. I have to choose array. So this is array, comma, row number is given by match function, column number I have to choose. First is ID, second is population, second is state, third is population. I want ID, so I will write 1. If I want area 2, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 will be the number. So this is match index. We'll look up.
Yes. I think yes, Mukul, we have overshot time a little bit. So we can wrap up and we can take a quick 5 minutes question answer because we have some little time left. So anyone having a question, you can please put it in the chat box or unmute and ask.
If I have to, hi Mukul, Paresh here.
Hello.
हाँ अगर जो फ्रीक्वेंटली अपडेट होता है ऐसा डेटा जैसे अगर इंपोर्ट करना है तो कैसे करेंगे. सॉरी आई मिस प्रोबेबली दैट पार्ट ऑफ इट.
ओके आई विल लाइक इंपोर्टिंग फ्रॉम वेबसाइट और समथिंग लाइक दैट.
हाँ
so
especially if the website is also you have subscription to it but it is in a sense protected data or paid data aise case mein
to possible nahi but if it is displayed on website publicly then there are tablet tables like what I have shown in one of the example. Section right left India JS importing, I think so. Importing data. Okay, this was a URL. So this data is embedded in this website. This is article. If this is embedded in and this is dynamic, we can import in by the same thing. Copy the link. Go to the data tab, import from web. You will be asked URL, so give it URL. Whatever, if data is dynamic, like instead of this area something is changing, that's okay. You go to there, give the link. You will get the table. Table will be read by this thing. This is one thing. This is second. The list of all the tables will be here. You have to choose which table you want and then transport data or directly you can. For transport data, you can have some cleaning, basic cleaning, and then load and close. So all the data will be imported and frequency of refresh can be set up, I think so. So accordingly for stock market data directly can be imported by NSC website and indices can be calculated based on that. But there is some lag in refreshing the data and kind of thing. You can set refresh automatically by going to into the options. So there is some setting. And for dynamic data such as ECMAC website or CSR portal, we have to change year every time or kind of thing, then we can use macros that I have planned for next session, tomorrow session, but due to time lag we will decide what to do about that. We'll certainly show that thing.
Okay
no doubts. Okay.
Yes, so we'll be meeting tomorrow again, same time. And please feel free to put out your doubts. Okay, all the resources which have been used are shared by Mukul on the chat. There's a drive link which is there.
Mm-hmm.
You can use those things.
And there is one basic formulas worksheet also there in session one file. So you can practice there. There is some informative things also available. So you can try that.
Yes. Okay. All right. Thank you very much.